everyone. Hope you're having a great day so far. Wanted to hop on here and talk to you guys about the importance of seeking God first in your personal life. And when you do that, every other part of your life will fall into place. You know, as a Christian, prayer is one of the most critical things that we can do and stay plugged into on a regular basis. The devil will always try to attack your prayer life because he knows that your prayer life is what holds him back and what defeats the devil. Amen? And so I think for a lot of us, as Christians, we kind of approach prayer in a lackadaisical way in our lives a lot of the time, and we wonder why we're under so much, you know, attack 24/7. And to a certain extent, attack comes, and it's actually a sign that you're on the right track, because the devil likes to attack those that he deems to be a threat. But some of it is actually preventable, you guys, and a lot of it is because we're not locked into our prayer closet on a regular basis. So a lot of people will pray pretty much only when they need something or in a time of crisis. I would say that's probably a large majority of the body of Christ. And I want to tell you guys, that's a large reason that so many people are under such heavy attack 24/7. It's not, you know, the only contributing factor. I think that you should definitely not feel guilty if you've been under attack. You know, it could just be that you're doing so much good for Jesus that you're a big threat, you know. But sometimes it's because we have lapsed in the place of prayer that we're seeing an increased amount of attack over our personal lives. And so that's why it's so important that we are seeking God first for who he is, not for just what he can give us in our personal lives. You know, my favorite definition of prayer is one that's not commonly spread around, but I like to say it like this. Prayer is simply communion with God. Amen. And so the most powerful people are in prayer are those who their prayer life is just as consistent on the mountaintop when their life is going exactly the way they want it to, versus when they're in the valleys, right? And that's a rare crowd out there that actually, you know, has that same consistency. You know, my prayer times with God, they look drastically different. You know, some days I'm interceding for other people. Some days I'm praying about stuff that I've got going on in my personal life. But a lot of days, it's kind of funny, if you guys would read parts of my prayer journal, when I go into some of my prayer times, it looks like, God, I don't know what to pray about today, but I'm here, you know? And some days it's just sitting there with God and communing with him in his presence. Like I said, prayer is simply communion with God. Amen. And so I think a lot of the times what we do is we go into prayer times and we do all the talking. We lay out our laundry list of requests for God, and then we get up and we leave the prayer time. But prayer, when it's done the way that God intends, really should kind of be intertwined with worship. It should feel kind of like a soaking, you guys. You know, I was in a worship time with me, myself, and I a few nights ago, and I was just having worship, just sitting there, not doing anything, just kind of resting. I wasn't even actively like praying for anything, but I was just kind of hanging out with Jesus. And he dropped an area of my life where I had had some pain that I didn't even know about, and he brought it to the surface and he started working on it, all from just giving him that space and that time. And I think so often we go into prayer times with an agenda, and it's not necessarily bad. God wants to hear about those prayer requests, but I think that sometimes we just need to hang out with God for the sake of hanging out with God, and we need to present our hearts to him and say, God, this is what's going on in my life. This is what's on my heart today. But God, show me what's on your heart. Help me just to hang out. You know, a silly example I like to give when it comes to prayer and just communing is my bestie and I. She and I are prayer partners and accountability partners, and we've just been friends for years and years now. And one thing that we will do sometimes is we'll call each other on the phone at night, and we'll just sit there and we'll talk for a little bit, but then we'll just kind of hang out together and not say a word. We're both working on different stuff, doing stuff, probably a huge waste of a phone bill, right? but we're sitting there, and that's what we do, and it's not uncomfortable. You know, she's a person who I can go on car rides with her, and we can talk and giggle and laugh for a couple hours, but then we can sit the next 2 or 3 hours in silence together because, you know, we're good. It's not awkward turtle, right? Because we know each other so well. And I think that that's the place where we've got to get to with Jesus, you guys. Sometimes, you know, especially those of you guys, if you have a quality time love language, I don't. But this is especially good for you guys. Sometimes God just wants you to hang out with him, period. Like, just to hang out in his presence. But the problem is, guys, we have to be purposeful to give him that space. I wonder how many encounters we are missing with the Lord because we're staring at our phones, because we're spending 4 or 5 hours a day on television. And I'm not saying any of that in itself is inherently bad. It's not, you guys. But you've got to create the space for God to talk to you. Some of the people that I know who have the deepest walks with the Lord are those who create the space for Him every single day. And it looks different for different people. You know, me personally, I like to talk to God first thing when I wake up in the morning. And I like to have a little bit of God time right before bed, because I notice that if my thoughts are focused on Scripture and if I've had some time with Him right before bed, I usually dream better. You know, I'm more at peace with my mind. It helps me to fall asleep better, you know. So that's just kind of my routine. But you've got to do you. And, you know, ultimately, the Bible tells us to pray continually. And, you know, a lot of people misinterpret that. They think that you've got to be praying up a storm out loud 24/7. That's not what that means. But prayer is communion with God. So I'm talking to God all throughout my day. You know, I have those set times that I give Him space to move and to talk to me. But, you know, I'm talking to God all throughout the day. You know, I'm saying, God, I'm struggling right now. Can you help me in this area? You know, God, I need help finding my car keys. Can you help me to do that? You know, it's amazing how much God cares about those little things in our life, those simple things, and how actively He wants to be involved. And so when we seek God first, you know, Scripture tells us, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and then all these things will be added unto you. I think we're so guilty a lot of the time of not seeking Him first. We seek after the opportunities, we seek after things, and then after the fact, we all ask His opinion about it, after we've already been through pain and hurt and all this stuff. And God's saying, if you would just seek me first, put me first in your day. And it's not wrong for you to step out on things, but when you put me first in your day, I'm going to tell you whether or not you have peace on situations. I'm going to show you the way. I'm going to give you guidance and direction in areas that you didn't even know you needed it in your personal life. And I think that's the other thing where we can get a little almost prideful in ourselves. A lot of times we think that we know what we need from God. You know, we'll go into a prayer time, we'll present our requests, and we won't leave Him any room to move. But I found in my personal life, I only see a very small portion of the big picture. And a lot of the times, the things that I think we need to work on the most are not the things that God thinks that we need to be working on the most. God is so often trying to align my thought life, my heart stance, so that He can deliver those things into my life. And I found that I am so much more action-oriented a lot of the time. I'm so much more focused on receiving that breakthrough in the natural. And God's going, I've already got that taken care of. I took care of that on the cross. I've had a plan for your life since before the day you were born. But He's going, I'm needing to work on the inside of you. And that comes through a place of dwelling. That comes through a place of communion with Him that we can only get through putting Him first in our days and through just simply hanging out in His presence. And so I want to encourage you guys today, if there are any areas of your life where you're seeking God for answers, where you really need His intervention in a situation today, go and just hang out with Him. You know, be like that friend who you don't have to have an agenda, but you can just go in and say, God, what's on your heart today? What would you have to say to me? And I want to encourage you guys to just take some time to be quiet. You know, take some time to worship, take some time to just get your mind off of the things of this world and to focus your attention on God. And when you do that, and when you put Him first, then all of those things that you have been worried about will be added unto you. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.